He kept his eyes half closed and looked through the slits of them at Ozma and Dorothy, who rose to receive him. "Are you the Supreme Dictator of the Flatheads?" inquired Ozma.
"Yes, that's me," he said, rubbing his hands slowly together. "My word is law. I'm the head of the Flatheads on this Flatheadland."
"I am Princess Ozma of Oz, and I have come from the Emerald City to—"
"Stop a minute,"
interrupted the Dictator, and turned to the man who had brought the girls there.
"Go away, Dictator, fellow Flathead,"
he commanded.
"Return to your duty and guard the stairway. I will look after these strangers."
The man bowed and departed, and Dorothy asked wonderingly, "Is he a dictator, too?"
"Of course," was the answer. "Everybody here is a dictator of something or other. They're all office holders. That's what keeps them contented. But I'm the supreme dictator of all, and I'm elected once a year. This is a democracy, you know, where the people are allowed to vote for their rulers. A good many others would like to be supreme dictator, but as I made a law that I am always to count the votes myself, I am always elected."
"What is your name?" asked Ozma.
"I am called the Su-Dic, which is short for Supreme Dictator. I sent that man away because the moment you mentioned Ozma of Oz and the Emerald City, I knew who you are. I suppose I'm the only Flathead that ever heard of you, but that's because I have more brains than the rest."
Dorothy was staring hard at the Su-Dic.
"I don't see how you can have any brains at all," she remarked, "because the part of your head is gone where brains are kept."
"I don't blame you for thinking that," he said. "Once the Flatheads had no brains, because, as you say, there is no upper part to their heads to hold brains. But long, long ago, a band of fairies flew over this country and made it all a fairyland, and when they came to the Flatheads, the fairies were sorry to find them all very stupid and quite unable to think.